Good morning. Today we're going to use a toy car and a large piece of paper to do an introductory relative motion problem.
Hey guys.
Hey, Bob.
Hi, Bob.
Flippin' physics.
Bobby, could you please read the problem just through part A? We'll get to parts B and C later today.
An introductory relative motion problem?
Sure. A toy car travels at 46 millimeters per second north relative to a piece of paper that is moving at 75 millimeters per second west relative to the Earth. Part A, what is the velocity of the toy car relative to the Earth?
Now, Bobby, could you please read again, and Bo, could you please translate?
A toy car travels at 46 millimeters per second north relative to a piece of paper that
is... please. The velocity of the toy car with respect to the paper is 46 millimeters per second north.
Yes, we write V sub C and then P for the velocity of the car with respect to the paper. Bobby, please continue.
That is moving at 75 millimeters per second west relative to the Earth.
Stop. Please write V sub P and then E for the velocity of the paper with respect to the Earth, and it's equal to 75 millimeters per second west.
Bobby, please keep going.
Part A, what is the velocity of the toy car relative to the Earth?
V sub C and then E for the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth equals question mark.
Great. Now let's take a moment to visualize the problem. We know the car moves at 46 millimeters per second north with respect to the paper. In other words, if the car were not on top of the paper, it would simply travel northward. And the paper is moving at 75 millimeters per second westward. Please take a moment and point in the general direction you think the car is going to move when we place it on the paper. You are all correct. It should move in a direction that is somewhere between north and west. Let's put the car on the paper and see what happens. And you can see that we are correct. The car moves somewhere between north and west. Now let's add our tip-to-tail vector diagram. You can see that the velocity of the car with respect to the paper plus the velocity of the paper with respect to the Earth is equal to the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth, which is, of course, an equation. Again, the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth is equal to the velocity of the car with respect to the paper plus the velocity of the paper with respect to the Earth. And just like the last problem we did, the common subscript, either on the inside or the outside, drops out and you end up with the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth. Bobby, could you please solve for that, the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth?
This looks exactly like the problem we did when you introduced vector addition, is it?
Absolutely, Bobby, you are correct. And I've done that on purpose, actually, to show that relative motion is vector addition. Now, please solve part A.
We have a right triangle, so we can use the Pythagorean theorem, or A squared plus B squared equals C squared. So the velocity of the car with respect to the paper squared plus the velocity of the paper with respect to the Earth squared equals the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth squared. Take the square root of both sides to get the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth is equal to the square root of the velocity of the car with respect to the paper squared plus the velocity of the paper with respect to the Earth squared. We have those numbers, so it's the square root of 46 squared plus 75 squared, which works out to be 87.983 millimeters per second. With two sig figs, that is 88 millimeters per second. The velocity of the car with respect to the Earth is 88 millimeters per second.
The velocity of the car with respect to the Earth is 88 millimeters per second. The velocity of the car is 88 millimeters per second.
Oh, man, I forgot direction.
That's right, velocity is a vector.
And vectors have both magnitude and direction.
Yep, velocity is a vector, has both magnitude and direction. So, Billy, please figure out theta.
We know tangent of theta equals opposite over adjacent, which means it will be equal to the velocity of the paper with respect to the Earth divided by the velocity of the car with respect to the paper. Taking the inverse tangent of both sides gives us that the theta equals the inverse tangent of the velocity of the paper with respect to the Earth divided by the velocity of the car with respect to the paper. We can substitute in numbers to get the inverse tangent of 75 divided by 46, which works out to be 58.478 degrees. With two safe bakes, that's 58 degrees, which means the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth is 88 millimeters per second at an angle of 58 degrees. I don't remember how to do the cardinal direction thing.
That's okay. I'll help you figure it out. Just remember that the easiest way to do it is to draw a compass rose on the tail of your vector. Theta is the direction west from north, so it's west of north. So the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth is approximately 88 millimeters per second at an angle of 58 degrees west of north. And you can see that direction matches well to our demonstration. Now let's work on part B. Bobby, Bo, please.
Part B, if the width of the paper necessary for the toy car to cross is 69.2 centimeters, how far did the toy car actually travel?
So something equals 69.2 centimeters north and something else equals question mark. I know they're both displacements, but I don't really know what variables to use. Maybe delta y is 69.2 centimeters north because the width of the paper is in the y direction?
Correct. The displacement in the y direction is 69.2 centimeters, and that is north. And we're looking for the displacement along the hypotenuse, which I have labeled delta d. Bo, could you please find the displacement along the hypotenuse?
We need to draw a new triangle with the displacements.
Oh, yeah. And it'll be a similar triangle to the first one we drew.
And we need to convert the displacement in the y direction to millimeters so the dimensions are the same. So multiply the displacement in the y direction by 1 meter over 100 centimeters, and then by 1,000 millimeters over 1 meter, and we get 692 millimeters north for the displacement in the y direction.
Let's talk about the similar triangles for a moment. We have a triangle with all velocity vectors, and we have a triangle with all displacement vectors. Please never try to put different dimensions on the same triangle of vectors. You need to make sure that the dimensions are the same so that they will always play well together. Bo, please continue.
Let's see, because they're similar triangles, they will have the same value for cosine.
Bo, for cosine of theta.
So the cosine of theta equals adjacent over hypotenuse, which equals the velocity of the car with respect to the paper, divided by the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth, which is then equal to the displacement in the y direction divided by the hypotenuse displacement. We're solving for delta d, so I'll multiply both sides by the hypotenuse displacement, which will cancel out delta d on the right-hand side. Then we can multiply by the inverse of the two velocities to cancel out the velocity on the left-hand side. And we get that the hypotenuse displacement equals the y displacement times the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth, all divided by the velocity of the car with respect to the paper. With numbers, that's 692 times 87.983, all divided by 46, which is 1,323.57 millimeters. With two sig figs, that's 1,300 millimeters.
To me how 1300 millimeters is the correct answer, even though it does not have a direction.
Part B asks for how far the car traveled, and how far means the distance traveled, not the displacement.
And we figured out the magnitude of the displacement, which is the same as the distance traveled, because the car was moving in a straight line.
And now part C. Bobby and Bo, please.
Part C. How long did it take the toy car to cross the paper?
Change in time equals question mark.
Billy, it's your turn.
We know the car is moving at a constant velocity, so let's use that equation. Velocity equals displacement over change in time. Substituting in our variables, we get that the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth equals the displacement along the hypotenuse divided by the change in time. Solving for the change in time gives us the change in time equals the displacement along the hypotenuse divided by the velocity of the car with respect to the Earth. With numbers, that is 1,323.57 millimeters divided by 87.983 millimeters per second. The millimeters cancel out, and we get
15.043 seconds, which rounds to 15 seconds with two sig figs.
And notice that it doesn't actually matter which side of the triangles you choose to use, as long as you use the same side of each triangle. We could choose the vertical sides of the triangles, and we end up with the velocity of the car with respect to the paper is equal to the displacement in the y direction divided by the change in time. When you solve that, you actually get the exact same time. That completes the problem. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.